Hey everybody, welcome back. Another episode, Outdoors with Bradley and Darrin.
It's been a minute.
Been a little while. Most of everybody knows. Been a lot going on in the world lately.
Yeah, work kind of got in the way too. So
yeah, work and, everything going on with everybody being, at home with their families and holidays. But we're back.
Yep.
So here we are today talking about ammo and what kind of rifles and calibers for deer hunting. All right.
Yeah, this was actually a request from a viewer. So they provided us with the We Are the People holster t-shirts here.
Yeah, very nice.
And requested a certain topic. So their topic was what calibers to use for deer hunting, because they're fairly new to deer hunting, just getting into it. So instead of actually going over the guns themselves, we're going to go over the ammunition, because the ammunition is more important than the gun, because you can use one caliber for various applications. Like, yeah, if you want to use your .30-06, for instance, you've got a ballistic tip for long range, then you've got a core lock and a power point that you can use for close range, knocking through thick brush, things like that. Same with the 30-30 here. It's a fairly flat nose. It's going to give you more, stability through brush.
Yeah.
So we'll touch on some of these topics right quick. But for the main thing, we're not going to talk about the guns themselves, like I said, but more about the ammo. So what we have here is a variety of different ammunitions. We've got 30-30, we've got 7 mag, 308, I believe this is 270, 30-06, and then one that most people don't use, the 450 Bushmaster. It's a little bit of overkill, but I wanted it, so I got it. So probably I'm going to say, I don't know about you, but one of the most common calibers that she used is going to be the .30-06.
I was going to say .30-06.
Or the 270. That's going to be the two that's, used the most around our part of the woods, would be these two. They're the most versatile. Like I said, you can get different tips, different projectiles for different applications. Here with the 30-06, we show that we have a power point, then we show we have a core lock, and then we have a ballistic tip, which is three different options here. I'm going to say the ballistic tip, you go for a long range.
That's your long range.
Yeah, that's your long range. I believe these are 125 grain, and then you go into your core lock and your power point. Your core lock is going to be, I think they're 180 grain,
165.
And then you go into your power point here, which you can vary upwards of 180 grains of that. And these two options right here, they're going to give you the more, the best application for your thick brush cover. Like, let's say you're hunting in pines with a lot of undergrowth, those are going to drive through the undergrowth, whereas this one right here, typically if you're shooting a ballistic tip through cover, it's going to deflect a lot. So if you're going to shoot a 30-06, make sure you use different bullets for different applications.
And I was going to touch on that. So you actually recently got harvested a deer from your hunting property.
Yes,
down south Alabama. And in your property, if I'm not mistaken, from what I remember, you've got different kinds of areas to shoot, lanes of shooting.
So, yeah,
so there could be some shooting through the woods, mm-hmm. and there could be some, if I'm not mistaken, you said 257 yards is what you shot that deer at?
Yeah, and I shoot a 7 mag, which is, the ammo we have here. We got a silver ballistic tip. We've got a Hornady red ballistic tip. We've got a power point, and then another type of power point here. So my go-to to where when I'm shooting long range is my my silver tip ballistic here. The reason why is because I actually sighted my rifle in with that, so that's what my gun actually prefers.
Yeah.
You'll notice that too, that when you start experimenting with different rounds, your gun shoots one more consistently than the other one. And then also, this is 150 grain. Then I go into the ballistic tip from Hornady, which is another soft point, fairly pointy tip. And it's going to go for the longer range applications too. And it's 139 grain. And then the two power points here, like I said, I would rather use in the thicker brush areas. Yeah. And those are upwards of, I think they're 185 grain. I've got a box somewhere, but I think they're 185 grain. So, you know, you've got different variations of ballistics here. So it just depends, you know, what application you're going to use. Long range, I'm going to go with a more aerodynamic, more streamlined projectile. And then when I go through thick brush, I'm going to go with a more, almost like a bulky type ammo.
Yeah, you want that weight to help push you through the brush.
You definitely want the weight, and then also you definitely don't want the ability to have deflection with your projectile.
So talking about brush and just going along with that topic, for me personally, if I was hunting thick brush, I would probably choose 30-30,
yeah,
which is what we've got right
here.
Yeah,
this is a Federal 30-30. I believe it is a 150 grain, another kind of, not really round nose, but another PowerPoint type application here. And actually, I was talking to one of my coworkers today about going and trying a different type of method deer hunting. Next time I go down to where I'm actually hunting from the ground, in the pines.
Okay.
So I'm not going to be up in a tree stand or shooting house. I'm going to be on the pines. And this is the gun that I believe I'm actually going to use, because this is probably the best application for this gun in the brush. 30-30 is a highly used caliber. I hunted with it for several years whenever I first started, you know, 20 some odd years ago, and shot deer up close, and then also shot deer far away with it. So it's versatile too. But I would say, and I would agree with you, that if you are going thick brush, go with the 30-30. It never fails. And then you have another common round, which would be the 308. We have a few options for that as well. You have two different power points here, and then another ballistic tip. Again, 308's a fairly long distance gun anyway, so you're not really going to tell. If you're shooting for distance, you're not really going to tell much between these three rounds here. But I would say, again, if I was going to shoot brush, I would not shoot the ballistic tip. I would shoot the two power points.
Yeah, that makes sense.
Again, it's going to give you the deflection capability where it's not deflected going through that brush, and everything. And also, these are 180 grains. And then this is 110, I believe.
That's significant.
Yeah.
That's a significant difference.
Yeah. And the weight of them. I mean, when you're talking about that, you're talking about your muzzle velocity. Let's just go through it real quick. Your muzzle velocity between 110 at 3,300 feet per second.
See, muzzle velocity, this is 180 grain. You're talking 2,620.
Yeah. So you're definitely pretty significant.
Yeah, that's a significant difference.
Yeah.
And with that lower velocity comes a little bit more, I would say, a little bit more accuracy through the sticks and the brush and stuff. Because with that thing humming along at, what, 3,300 feet per second, if it hits a twig, it's going to deflect.
Yep. So what's your energy foot-pounds at muzzle?
2743.
So here we're at 2660.
Yeah.
So you're going to have a little bit more kinetic energy with the heavier round.
Step it out to 100, though.
Yeah.
Step it out to 100.
2132.
Yeah, 2287. Yeah, so a little over 100 foot-pounds.
Yeah, to me, I always like shooting ballistics long range.
Yeah.
You know, like we said, I did harvest a deer this past weekend at 257 yards. I was able to watch it expire within, I don't know, 40 yards of where it shot. And again, I was shooting the Winchester silver tip ballistic. That makes every deer that I've shot with that, I've been able to watch them, you know.
Yeah.
Watch them expire.
Watch them fall.
So, you know, I've shot them up close. I shot a 10 point, probably within 50 yards in Kentucky. Shot a 9 point within 50 yards in Kentucky. I shot a 8 point at 294 yards. And it ran probably 30 yards from where it was. I shot another 8 point at 185 yards. And then the one the other day at 257 yards. So, this is my go-to round, the 7mm with the silver ballistic tip.
Mm-hmm.
That's what I've shot. They're a little expensive, $43 box.
That's so, a little expensive.
Yeah, so I try not to
don't waste
shoot
those.
No more than I have to. so we've covered the 7mm, the 270, the 30-06, the 30-30, and the 308. Another one that we brought to the table, which, again, is not going to be a common round that people shoot, is the 450 Bushmaster, which again is going to come in several different variations of the same bullet. You know, I have the Hornady Black here in 250 grain. It is a ballistic red tip, and then also they go, you know, they do have the round nose. I don't know if they have a core lock or not, but then they do have very similar to a full metal jacket.
Mm-hmm.
Like when you see with a 45 and stuff, it's kind of got the flat nose and then kind of cone shaped off of that.
Yep.
They've got that too. That would be that would be the application for if you're, you know, brush hunting again.
Yeah.
You know, you go with that kind of bulky bull nose projectile, whereas if you're shooting a little bit longer with this one right here, you're going to want to go with the ballistic. And I mean, so with this one here, you know, our velocity that we're running on it is 2200 feet per second.
Yeah.
And then let's say from 200 to 300 yards, you're dropping 19 inches. You know, that's something that you're not going to use long range. You know, I'm going to say with this, you could be good with 100 to 200 yards pushing it. You know, you're hitting, I think there's a 4-inch variation.
Yeah.
So if you zero at 200, you're 4 inches high at 100.
Yeah.
So if you're shooting at 200 and you're zero to 100, you're going to be low.
Yeah.
But again, this is something that I don't recommend for somebody that's going to have several different scenarios to shoot. If it was me and I was just a first time hunter, new hunter, I mean it's kind of a personal preference. There is what it comes down to, is do you want to do the common 270, the common 306, the 308, or do you want to change it up and go with the 7mm?
That's a lot of gun. That's a lot of gun for a first time hunter.
It is it is a whole lot of gun.
I say, just in comparison.
Yeah.
You got what? 7mm Magnum, 30-06, 270, and 308.
Yep. Right there. And so your velocity at muzzle on a 7mm Magnum is 3,100 feet per second.
Yeah, that's...
And then when you go up to 100 yards, you go down to 2,903.
Yeah.
So, benefit of it is you're able to carry that velocity further, but you're also going to do more damage to the animal, resulting in meat loss.
Yeah. If you're hunting up close, let's say you're hunting within 100 yards.
Yeah.
You know, between, 50 and 150,
mm-hmm.
right? You're going to want if I'm not mistaken, you're going to want that lower velocity so that you don't have the meat loss.
Yeah, for sure.
You know, you don't want to damage, and, heaven forbid you hit some other organ, intestines, stomach, something like that. If you hit them with a 7mm Magnum, you're going to lose a little bit more meat than if you were to hit them with a 308 or even a 450 Bushmaster,
yeah.
I think.
Yeah, for sure.
The 450 Bushmaster might have a lot of punch, but it's also...
Lower velocity.
Yeah, lower velocity. It's not going to carry through.
It's gonna do more more impact damage. It's going to carry throughout, whereas if you're shooting this, it's kind of like you're saying, it's going to speed through.
Mm-hmm.
You know, you're going to do damage, especially if you hit vital organs. And that's another thing that plays into this factor as well, is your ability to consistently have perfect shot placement in reference to the vitals. I've shot most of my deer in the front vitals, which I mean the heart and the lungs. I did shoot one in the neck one time, and it did fall. But again, it's a lot of damage coming from this round here. So I would say that the first time hunter needs to, I would even throw this out here for the first time.
Yes, I agree.
You know, 30-30, you can get the same scenarios from this smaller round. You can get the ballistic tip, the flat nose, the core lock, the power point, whatever you feel is adequate for the situation, you can get that from this 30-30. Which again, this is, I think the majority of them you find now are lever action steel. You get the Marlin and the Winchester, and I believe maybe a Mossberg, but I think they're all still...
Henry still makes a lever action 30-30 as well.
I think they're all... I don't recall seeing a bolt action 30-30. I do have one, though. It's an old Savage, so they do make them. It's just very old. But these would be my four go-tos for any new type of hunter. The 308, the 270, the 30-06, and then the 30-30. And then, go ahead, sorry.
Oh, no, sorry, clear my throat.
No. And then, after you get some time in, after you made some successful harvest, then you may want to start experimenting with a different round, or a different gun altogether.
Or if you travel to a new location.
Yeah.
You know, a lot of hunting depends on, a lot of cartridge and rifle... choices depend on where you're hunting.
Animal as well.
Yeah, and the animal.
You know, you're definitely not going to go elk or bear hunting with a 30-30. You're going to go elk or bear hunting with the 7mm. And also, I've heard of some people going elk hunting with a 30-06 and a 270.
I have heard of a 270
being
used. So, while all are capable,
I'm going with a more firepower.
Yeah,
for sure.
With bigger game animal, you probably want to go with that bigger cartridge.
Yeah, just to be on the safe side, especially if you're hunting dangerous game, like a bear.
I'm get the biggest I can.
Yeah, I'm definitely not going into a bear fight with a 308. Of course, that's going to come. I mean, if you're confident in your shot and can, make a clean headshot, you could do it. But again,
we can't hunt bear here now.
Exactly. And it comes down to first selecting the right gun for you, That also means, you know, holding the weapon, making sure you're comfortable with it, practice, you know, coming up on target from a sitting position or something like that,
yeah,
to get comfortable with it, and then, you know, multiple rounds on target at the range.
Yeah,
for sure.
And along with that, you know, we're just a couple of guys that have been shooting for a long time.
Yeah,
yeah. You know, by no means are we professionals. So with that being said, go to your local gun store. You know, surprisingly enough, they are very knowledgeable, mm-hmm, when it comes to what you're trying to hunt, what your capabilities are as a shooter, mm-hmm, and, you know, and they might be able to point you in a better direction.
Yeah.
You know, they might, you might be thinking 7 mag, and they might point you in a little bit of a 270 direction, you know, and it just depends on your level of expertise as a shooter.
Yep.
And your, you know, how comfortable you are with rifles, hunting, because when you're shooting at a steel target or a paper target or whatever, is a lot different than when you're staring down the scope,
yeah,
or the sights, looking at an animal that you're trying to harvest, mm-hmm, thinking about feeding your family, thinking about what it's going to do for you,
yeah,
you know, and thinking about taking that, you know, that life that was,
yeah,
put on earth, you know,
it's 1,000 times different, you know.
Yeah.
I've had guys that could sit there and shoot bottle caps at 100 yards with a bow and arrow, and then when it comes time to it and you got a deer standing in front of you, they can't pull it back.
They're shaking so much they, yeah, couldn't hit a
so,
broadside, you know, of a barn.
Right? Yeah. And it's something that you have to factor in as well. And then also another thing too is you don't want to get too much gun to where you're anticipating a shot.
Mm-hmm.
And what I mean by that is it kicks so bad that you're just sitting there, oh God, I don't want to do it, and you're, yep, anticipating that, and you're not properly prepped for the shot, and then you're also not properly following through with the shot.
Yeah.
So a couple different things to recap real quick. I know it's been we're covering a lot, but the main things for selecting the correct caliber for you is know your situation as far as the area you're hunting, your level of shooting and then hunting as well, your comfortability with the gun, and I would say those would be probably the three most important.
Probably the three, yeah. I would agree.
You know, a lot of, like, I started out with 30-06. Or, sorry, I started out with a 30-30. Then I stepped up to a 30-06. Then I went to 308. And then now I shoot the 7 mag. And I shoot the 7 mag religiously. Like, I have all of these guns. I have the 7 mag, the 30-30, the 450, the 308. I have all of them. But my go-to gun is my 7 mag. And it's just because I'm so comfortable with that gun. I know how it shoots. I know where the bullets go, and I know how to compensate for my yardage and everything. So that is my gun that I go to the hunt with.
Yeah. And for me, if I had to choose one, it would be the 308.
Yeah.
I'm the same way with the 308.
Yeah.
You know, while my bullet drop might be a little bit more at a little bit longer distance, as I've talked about before, I've shot a lot of 308.
Yeah.
And I'm comfortable with that bullet drop.
Yeah. So...
so
that plays a big factor, yeah, into it, is being comfortable with your weapon.
Yeah, know your equipment. Mm-hmm. It's a very, very big thing, especially if you're a first time hunter, first time shooter. Buy you a box just to get familiar
with it. It may be a little hard right now, but
yeah.
But do it anyway.
Yeah. Spend that little bit extra money.
Yeah.
Get you a box of ammo that you're just gonna put through that weapon. And just to see how it feels, number one, see how it reacts at different distances.
Yeah,
that's going to be key. Is trying to figure out what your weapon is going to do at different distances, because you don't know where the deer are going to walk out, right?
Yeah, I mean, you know, it's kind of like what we were saying at my hunting property. What, buddy? What's my pet tomato saying? It's right there. It's right there in the chair. The scenario to where I was at yesterday, you know, we're hunting a power line, and I have the ability to make a shot from 10 yards to, honestly, I shoot 1,200 yards.
I was
going to
say, I've seen that picture.
Yeah,
it's a long way out.
It's a very long way.
We'll try to put a little bit of the picture that Bradley sent up in this area right here.
Yeah. Yeah, and then also I can kind of go on one of my hunt stand or my hunt wise apps or whatever it is, one of the hunting apps, and you can actually draw the distance from point A to point B, and it'll tell you in yardage what it is. That's how I've kind of said, you know, okay, I shot this animal at this distance and whatever. You know, I also shot a coyote with this one at it was like 240 something yards. I shot, you know, coyote with that. I've shot a coyote at 12 yards. I think at close range, a lot more damage. I had a hole in the back of the animal probably about that big. So, always practice predator control. So, you know, the main thing, buy something you're comfortable with. Everybody's going to tell you, you need to go this range or this round, this gun. This is what you need to do.
Yeah, you're not going to get that from us.
No.
We're not going to tell you that this is the go-to hunt round for a first-time shooter.
It's not at all. And it's, you know, I've got some guys now that are... I actually had a guy the same day that I shot my buck yesterday, which hopefully we can put a picture on it because it's a pretty unique buck and maybe you guys will like it and give us some comments and some feedback. But I shot it with a 7 mag. I was able actually to watch it expire. I had a guy that was hunting on the other side of the property, and he was shooting maybe the same distance. I don't really know. I can't recall where exactly he was at, but he was shooting a 300 mag. They never found his deer. So that just goes to show you. And actually, I believe the 7 mag is bigger, or the 300 is bigger than the 7 mag.
Yeah, because just a little bit of bullet terminology, a 30 caliber round, which is going to be your 30-06, your 308, your 30-30, anything with a 30 in front of it is going to be at least 7.6 millimeters in diameter.
Yep.
There's going to be different changes. So this is actually a 7.62 by 54, if I'm not mistaken, a 30-06. And this is actually a 7.62 by 51, a 308. That's just a little bit of military terminology. And then this is just your regular 70 millimeter.
Yeah.
So there is a little bit more diameter in the 30-06 and the 308.
Yeah.
Just to throw that out.
And what it really comes down to is the powder in the casing.
Yeah.
How much velocity you get based off of the powder, the amount of powder you have in the casing. That's going to give you your velocity. What are you doing, Captain America? I'll fix it in a minute. Okay. That's going to give you your velocity, and then also it's going to help with your bullet drop.
Mm-hmm.
But the majority of what's going to come from that is the weight of your projectile.
Yeah.
You know, just like this where I'm shooting a 150 grain versus a 250 grain, I drop off way more with this one than with this one. 250 grain, 150 grain. 150 grain's going to have the longer reach with less drop. So, with everything said, like we said, the main thing is get something comfortable, repeatable. You don't want to be guessing every shot. You want to know where that bullet's going when you pull the trigger and be confident that you made a good clean hit.
Yeah.
That's the biggest thing. Other than that, you know, like Darrin said, you know, go visit your local gun store, talk to some of your hunting buddies. They're going to give you their variation of what they shoot. Like I said, I've got some guys that shoot the 270 short mag. Honestly, if you ask me, this is the one thing that I will say is to stay away from the 270 short mag. Stay away from it. I do not like that round. Every deer that I know that has been shot with a 270 short mag, we've had to track.
Really?
I don't feel confident in that round. And honestly, that's the only round that I don't feel confident in. Any of these right here, I feel confident in because I have experience with them.
Yeah.
The 300, I know guys that, you know, that's all they shoot. 300 ultra mag. I know people that shoot the 7mm short mag. 7mm 08, 25 alt 6. You know, it's just going to come down to personal preference and comfortability. That's what it comes down to. So, like we said, get a gun. And if you get one with a factory mounted scope, redo every bit of it.
Yeah.
Do
I can
not
speak from experience.
Do not trust a factory mounted scope. They say it's factory mounted and bore sided, all that stuff. Don't.
Yeah.
Next episode, well, we can't, can we? Can you show mount the scope?
We'll do it.
I mean, you're not technically modifying a gun.
Yeah, we'll do it anyway.
Okay, we'll show you how to mount one. Okay. It's not hard, and another thing that I will preach, other than redoing a factory mounted scope, Loctite.
Yes.
Use Loctite. I had a guy that I worked with. He was he actually had a gun. It was a 6.5 Creedmoor.
6.5 Creedmoor.
You know,
that's what I shoot.
You're different though. You're not one of those that, hey, I shoot a 6.5. You're not one of those guys. But anyway, no hating. It's a gun. Shoot it. If you feel comfortable with it, shoot it. Just don't tell everybody. But anyway, so he had a 6.5 Creedmoor that he had purchased with no scope on it. And then he did go and purchase a separate scope, separate rings, everything. And he mounted it. And he told me, oh, man, I'm good to go. I'm ready to go. And I said, did you Loctite it? Did you put Loctite on the base and the rings and the mounts? So it's three main areas, the only three areas of mounting scope, really. He said, excuse me, got something in my throat. He said, no, I didn't Loctite. I said, ooh, I'd be worried about that. So sure enough, he had a deer come out 30 yards. He missed it. So I said, okay. Bring it to me. We'll work on it. So we did. He brought it to me. We were able to take, and I stripped the whole thing down, remounted everything, rebore sided everything, and re-sided it in with. I used blue Loctite on his gun because I don't know how he wants to change things. The majority of mine, what I do is I buy the extended Picatinny rail. You may have seen it in one of the other videos that we've done, one of the earlier videos. What I do is I buy that extended base, right? So that's going to give you a lot of capability to change scopes because you're going to have some long tube scopes and short tube scopes. So buy that too. And we're going off on a tangent here just because that's where we ended up. So again, the main things with buying guns and starting to hunt with them is get comfortability with the gun. As Darrin said, you're going to want to buy a whole box to shoot through it. Not only the side of the end, but also to get comfortable with it. Like I said, your 7mm, they're going to be a little bit more expensive. These ballistic tips here come in at $43 a box. Your 30-06 ballistic tips, they come in at $27. These Hornady black 450 Bushmasters, I think they were like $27 a box. And then your 30-30 here, just your standard flat bullnose, $22 a box. You know, it's going to vary depending on how big of a caliber you get. Like if you get into some of the bigger, like I'm going to say dangerous game, like for bear hunting, for moose hunting, for if you want to go out to Africa and go dangerous game hunting, you're going to get into some rounds that are $100 a box easy. So, you know, that could also be another factor in to what you buy is the affordability of the ammo. Definitely not going to target practice with this. The 308, the good thing about the 308s is they make multiple types of rounds for 308. So you can buy some. How much is some of that ammo you buy for your 308? It's fairly cheap. I mean, it's not like it's the.
Probably 28 to $35 a box.
And then they make some that's just like a.
Make some that I call the cheap stuff.
Yeah.
And it's cheap.
And that's just something so you can.
That's your target practice.
That's your target practice, yeah. Just to go out and shoot and get comfortable with your weapon. You know, that's going to be what you use.
That's your $10 box.
Yeah.
That you can't really find much anymore.
Yeah. Yeah, you really can't. I actually had somebody go into Academy today looking for me some ammunition, and all they had was 28 gauge.
As I say, last time I went, there was nothing.
I looked up and I did find two boxes of 30-06 the other day. They were a little pricey, but I bought them. So I don't know if I have anything else to add other than, you know, the three main. Or we threw in another one, affordability.
Yeah.
You know, you definitely don't want to go shoot these at $43 a box. You know, you may want to shoot these at $22 a box.
Yeah.
But you can. What you can do is you can get your gun. You can sight it in. With these rounds here, which would be what you want to, this is your go-to ammo. We'll call this your go-to ammo. But then, like, you got a different scenario to where you want to shoot this. You know, get a box of this, shoot it, because they will fly different.
Yeah.
They will fly different, so you want to practice with both rounds. There's not much variation going to be in them, but it may be 4 inches to the left, 4 inches to the right, you know. We witnessed that with my dad's 270 short mag. He was shooting this type of round, and then he went to something like this, and he was hitting 4 inches to the left.
Yeah.
So we had to adjust. So practice.
Yeah, as I said, that's just things you learn to practice.
Yep. So again, the big things is comfortable. What else? Comfortable, repeatable.
Affordable.
And that's about it. I'm sure we covered some other stuff, but you know, the main things is comfortability, repeatability, and then affordability for the gun. You definitely don't want to buy something that you can't buy the ammo for.
Yeah.
So with all that said, I hope that, you know, this kind of sheds some light on selecting a proper caliber to start hunting with for a new time hunter or a first time hunter. Main piece of advice is don't do what everybody says do. You know, select it yourself based on what you want.
Do a little research.
Yeah.
See what might be right for you in your area or your land that you're going to be hunting on. If you're going to be hunting on private, you know, some land that you have, you know, pick what's right for you.
Yep.
So, don't listen to all those old timers that think they know it all.
Yeah. Yeah, you definitely don't want to go that, because then you may end up with a gun that you don't want to hunt with and
you don't like, and you just wasted your money.
Yep. So with all that said, I think we're going to wrap up. I think we pretty much covered the topic, but if you do have any questions, feel free to comment, and you know, we can answer those questions the best we can, or at least point you in the right direction.
Reach out to us on Instagram also.
Yeah.
Outdoors with Nug.
Yep.
Outdoors with Darrin.
Yep. Got some stuff coming up on there you guys may be interested in, so keep a watch for that.
Yeah, definitely keep an eye out. Got some big things coming up.
Yep, for sure. So next week, we'll show you how to mount a scope. And bore sighted. I don't really trust bore sighted, but you know, whatever. We'll show you how to bore sighted too.
So I do.
I don't. I've been burnt with it. You know, you think you're hitting, you should be hitting pretty good, but then you go out there 100 yards and put one on target and it's 4 foot too short.
So yeah.
We'll figure it out. But either way, next week we'll show you how to mount a scope from a factory bore sight and factory mount. Again, don't trust it. And then we'll go from there with it. And then hopefully we'll keep going with it. If you first time hunter, if you got another topic you want us to cover, let us know. We'll cover it too.
For sure.
Yep.
2021, new year.
Yeah. Finally.
Yeah. Yeah. We got through.
Yeah. We all did. We did. Ohio State's about to score. All right. So with that, we're going to sign off. Hope you guys enjoy it.
Yeah. Thanks for watching.
Hope you learned something.
Subscribe.
Yep. Hit the notification button.
Ding, ding, ding. Get that one. Because you don't know when we're going to post a video.
Yeah. You know, because we have normal lives,
too. Yeah. Yeah. Sorry.
Yeah. This is not our only job. So again, you know, sorry for the little bit of break we had, but like we said, we had a lot of stuff going on. Ohio State score.
That's what I'm talking about.
So, you know, all right, until next week, appreciate it.
See you guys later.